What other movie can you name where the villain convinces the hero that he's right? How often do you get that out of a movie?
The way forward is only possible because both of them existed. For him, revenge and justice are not two separate things. They coexist. One supports the other. Very often, the things that we do that are destructive, we do them because we're hurting. We do them because we want positive change, and we're doing it the only way we know how.
Well, he went about it the wrong way, right? Well, what was the right way? That's like what he's wanted the whole time was freedom. The weight of the struggles and pains of a whole community, like a black community, is just like all behind Killmonger.
It is as much a call for black leadership as it is for white repentance.
He's like pretty dang inspiring to me in this movie.
Hello and welcome to Cinema Therapy. I'm Jonathan Decker, licensed therapist who loves movies. This is
Alan Seawright, professional filmmaker who needs therapy, and we are joined today by Stacey Harkey, multi-talented, multi-hyphenate.
That's
tell
me.
The people who we are.
I am their one black friend. No, I'm just kidding.
I have three black friends.
Cool.
But basically, I am a sketch comedian. I'm a writer. I'm an actor. It's what I do, and I also do nonprofit work, DEI training, so
yeah,
this is great.
So Stacey is known for Studio C, which is Conan O'Brien's favorite family-friendly sketch comedy show.
You guys do a really nice job.
When he said that, I was like, I think I still haven't recovered from that moment. I know I was like, Conan, you're lying. I know you're lying, but I'll take it.
And now known for Freelancers.
Freelancers, yeah, with JK Studios.
So today we're going to be talking about Killmonger. We're doing villain therapy. Our villain therapy, just like our Psychology of a Hero series, goes to explore mental health and relationship struggles of our favorite characters. And if you struggle with mental illness, you are 10 times more likely to be a victim of violence than a perpetrator. So there is no link between mental illness and villainy. But our villains have struggles, and I know it's Alan, and my favorite MCU villain is Killmonger.
Killmonger might be my favorite movie villain, full stop.
Wait, like, why?
What other movie can you name where the villain convinces the hero that he's right?
Yeah.
He's right! Killmonger was right!
Yeah.
It is such an amazing story. I love this movie.
And I must admit, while I was watching Black Panther, I was like, who's the bad guy? Because right now I'm resonating with a lot of what Killmonger's talking about.
For sure. So we're gonna talk about the difference between revenge and justice and doing the right thing, but the wrong way. So let's dive in.
Giddy up. This is just such an awesome... Hi, here's your bad guy. What a great establishing shot.
Well, he's framed like Vader, you know?
I'm just checking out these artifacts.
Michael B. Jordan is so cool.
He's an expert.
It's upsetting how cool he is.
I want that hairstyle.
They're beautiful.
I don't think I should pull it off.
I think I would look like a little girl with it. I'm worried.
The Bobo Ashanti tribe, present-day Ghana, 19th century.
For real? And what about this one?
And he's pulling off that look, too, you know?
That one's from the Edo people of Benin.
But then he does look the way he does.
Yeah, it's easy to pull off an extreme look if you're that handsome.
What about this one?
It's true. It's the confidence.
Also from Benin, 7th century.
I mean, let's hear it for her. She's pulling off that look, too.
Tribe, yeah.
Believable curator.
Putting in work.
It was taken by British soldiers in Benin, but it's from Wakanda, and it's made out of vibranium. Don't trip. I'm going to take it off your hands for you.
These items aren't for sale.
How do you think your ancestors got these? You think they paid a fair price? Or did they take it like they took everything else?
Sir, I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
You got all this security in here watching me ever since I walked in. But you ain't checking for what you put in your body.
All right, mate, let's have it. Come on, mate, time.
I think she might not be feeling too good.
Hey, somebody get some help. Come here, call the doctor, please.
He pulls off so many different things in this scene.
Right off the bat, he's the coolest character in the movie.
He's so cool.
He might be the coolest character in any movie at this point.
Like, T'Challa's, like, cool as a hero, but, like, Killmonger's, like, cool. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
let's face it. T'Challa is a bit of a nerd.
His mission statement is baked into this first scene.
Yep.
But right out of the gate, he's talking about what the colonizers and what her ancestors did.
This episode is sponsored by Stamps.com. Does your inbox look more like a blizzard than a winter wonderland? Rushing to send cards and gifts to your loyal friends slash family slash clients? Right about now, holiday season excitement, or dread, is really starting to set in if you're anything like me. But it's not too late to get your holiday mailing and shipping under control with Stamps.com. Sign up now, and you'll be printing your own postage in minutes. No more trips to the post office. All you need is a computer and a printer. No lines, no traffic, no hassle. Stamps.com is your one-stop shop for all your shipping and mailing needs. It's a stress-free solution, especially for small businesses. We're using Stamps.com for the fulfillment of the Kickstarter we ran a few months ago, and instead of feeling stressed and overwhelmed that I have to ship 900,000 items to our backers, I'm just feeling holiday cheer. You can even save money, up to 86% off on US Postal Service and UPS shipping rates. With their switch and save feature, you can easily compare carriers and rates, since rates are constantly changing, and then you'll know that you're getting the best deal. For more than 20 years, Stamps.com has been indispensable for over a million businesses. Did you know you can even schedule a package pickup from your Stamps.com dashboard? Neat! And if you're running an online store, Stamps.com works seamlessly with all the major shopping carts and marketplaces. How many times can I say Stamps.com? You're gonna find out this holiday season. Trade late nights for silent nights, and get started with, that's right, Stamps.com. Sign up at Stamps.com/cinematherapy for a special offer that includes a 4-week free trial, plus free postage and a free digital scale. No long-term commitments or contracts. Just go to Stamps.com/cinematherapy, find out how much it's gonna cost to send that care package to Wakanda.
What are your thoughts on this? You seem like you got thoughts.
I'm just like, the theme, I feel like it's like such a theme throughout, where it's like, he's like functioning in the system that was, he was forced to be in.
Yeah.
Right? He talked about, oh, the colonizers took it. He's literally doing what colonizers did.
Yeah.
With the same tools. It's like playing by their rules.
Yeah. He says later, I'm going to beat them at their own game.
Yep.
You know, this is what he learned. And there's a juxtaposition that we see throughout the film of T'Challa is a compassionate, benevolent ruler, but he's also withdrawn and he only looks after his own.
You're a good man with a good heart, and it's hard for a good man to be king.
Mm-hmm. Right. Whereas Killmonger is vicious as hell, but he's looking after his people all over the world.
Right.
You know?
His own is not Wakanda. He's expanded it out to like this entire continent's worth of people and the diaspora around the globe.
Yeah. But I love how he switches from, you know, interested museum patron to an undercurrent of menace.
Mm-hmm.
To, hey, get some help over here, guys.
He really does feel like, and to say like this parallel or this juxtaposition of like the Black Panther, he feels like this like confident, like a predator, right? He feels like this giant tiger that's just like confident but cold, and you're like, any second he's gonna like, can just like snap.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, it's so good. Let's keep going.
That is how you shoot a villain. Mm. Come on.
I love scenes of people in handcuffs who are still completely in control.
Mm.
Yeah.
He's like, this is my new room. He's scoping it out.
Ted, speak. I'm standing in your house, serving justice to a man who stole your vibranium and murdered your people.
So much emotion in his face.
Justice your king couldn't deliver.
I love the drums.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah.
Who's playing the drums in this moment?
Yeah, that you brought Claw. Only reason I don't kill you where you stand is because I know who you are. Now what do you want?
We're cousins.
I want the throne. Hey, you, the tuna.
She has the best reaction.
Y'all sitting up here comfortable. Must feel good. It's about 2 billion people all over the world that looks like us. But their lives are a lot harder. Wakanda has the tools to liberate them all.
And what tools are those?
Vibranium. Your weapons.
Our weapons will not be used to wage war on the world. It is not our way to be judge, jury, and executioner for people who are not our own.
Not your own. But didn't life start right here on this continent? So ain't all people your people?
I am not king of all people.
They're both making really good points.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's not wrong.
It is my responsibility.
But neither is T'Challa.
Our people are safe, and that vibranium does not fall into the hands of a person like you.
Son, we have entertained the charlatan for too long. Reject his request.
Oh, I ain't requesting nothing.
Ask who I am.
You're Eric Stevens. An American black operative. A mercenary nicknamed Killmonger. That's who.
I love how he looks at T'Challa like, you know.
Princess. He's so confident.
Ask me, King.
No.
Ask me.
Take him away.
This moment.
Ungubani! Indingu Injadaka! Unyanaka Ndobu!
Huh? Unyanaka Ndobu?
I found my daddy with panther claws in his chest! You ain't the son of a king, you are the son of a murderer!
Uyapo Sisa! Lies!
I'm afraid not, Queen Mother.
What? You? Indanda Toka Ndobu.
Hey, Auntie.
Oh, man.
I'm exercising my blood right. The challenge for the mantles of King and Black Panther.
Even his teeth. Panther ass.
Mm-hmm.
Do not do this, T'Challa.
As the son of Prince Njobu, he is within his rights.
He has no rights here. The challenge will take weeks to prepare.
Weeks? I don't need weeks. The whole country ain't gotta be there. I just need him.
Oh, somebody man.
Get me out of these chains.
So much hate.
Mm-hmm.
So much hurt.
What do you know of this?
I accept your challenge.
So Alan said so much hate and you said so much hurt.
Yeah.
One leads to the other, right?
I think they're coming from
they definitely come, right? It's like that.
Yeah.
I think it's like, I mean, you see that a lot with like men, right? Where it's like you get hurt and it's like the only way to process this is to be angry. Yeah. Or to be mad, you know, to be violent or something.
There's a lot of stuff in the script that's very pointed and very powerful. Mm. And then there's a lot of stuff that is superhero hokum. Vibranium, the mantle of Black Panther, you know, and the only reason you buy it is because he sells the hell out of it. How do you do that?
I'm not in these kinds of movies.
No, but you've done stuff that has fantastical elements and things. And how do you, because you have to internally believe it so that it externally shows
exactly
that you
believe it,
right? So how do you do that?
When I'm acting and when I'm saying something that I think is absolutely insane, I try to put it in my own words. So it feels organic, and so it feels believable. And I have no idea what kind of, like, freedom they had to act in these kind of realms. And I imagine, I don't know, I would guess not much, but I don't know.
I don't know how Ryan Coogler works, because he's, you know, co-writer on the film. I get the feeling from interviews and stuff that he's much more collaborative with his actors. Mm. And frankly, if he's not, and he's working with Chadwick Boseman and Michael B. Jordan, that's dumb.
Yeah.
Let them massage your material, my friend.
Mm-hmm.
Well, but I assume that's what he's doing because they're so great. Like,
also, vibranium plays like it's more than just the weapon, right?
Yeah.
Obviously, it represents like the key to freedom, right? Mm-hmm. For Michael B. Jordan, Wakanda sees that as like their key to privilege, I guess. And losing vibranium would challenge that. But it's also like the main struggle of why his father was killed.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Is like vibranium. And whenever they talk about vibranium, I'm like, are you really just talking about your dad?
He sells it with an emotional weight that to him it suggests it's about something else.
It's gotta be something heavier than that.
Yeah. But what he lays on is his next phase here is we are gonna get revenge and we are gonna use our weapons and we're gonna liberate our people.
Yeah.
This is your last chance. Throw down your weapons and we can handle this another way.
I lived my entire life waiting for this moment. I trained, I lied, I killed just to get here. I killed in America, Afghanistan, Iraq. I took life from my own brothers and sisters right here on this continent. And all this death just so I could kill you.
And that's...
Let the challenge...
To me...
Begin.
He's got the mission statement that's in his head.
Mm.
That's...
Oh.
We're going to take our brothers and sisters and we're going to put them back where they should be, right?
Yeah.
We're the cradle of all civilization. We're going to be the rulers of all civilization.
Yeah.
What's in his heart is that.
Yeah.
I killed and I killed and I killed so I could kill you.
Mm. I feel like this is his origin story. He's not, like, copying colonizers or, you know what I mean? Or, like, trying to be the bad guy. He was literally made this way. This thing where it's like, dog eat dog. You have to fight. You have to kill. We've seen it through history. That's the only way you're going to get it. And I honestly, I see this and I'm like, I remember thinking like, okay, well, he went about it the wrong way, right? Well, what was the right way?
Yeah.
What would have been the right way to do... Well, like monumental change.
And that's the thing is, like, for him, there was no other way. Had T'Chaka taken him home, he could have said, hey, this is what I saw as a kid in the streets of Oakland. Our people are suffering. We can help them. Mm. But T'Chaka abandoned him, killed his father and abandoned him. And the psychology of revenge, because T'Challa didn't kill his father. Mm-hmm. Right. T'Chaka did. But T'Chaka's not around. And at this point, he's just got all this anger and he needs to direct at some player. You know, when he talks about all the people he killed. Yeah, well, you try and play it like it was just strategy to get to this moment, but every life you took was dealing with your father's death. Every life you took was dealing with the crap you saw in the streets of Oakland. Every life you took was you kind of like a Sith Lord, like letting the hate flow through you, right? Like to grow in power. Like,
well, and you can see because he physically put all of them on his body.
Yeah.
You don't do that because that hurts.
Yeah.
You don't do that for fun.
I don't see how he literally could have had another way. Because, like, whatever other way he could have gone about it or ways that people are trying now, and it really isn't making much of a difference, right?
Yeah.
Which seems really depressing and dismal, but it's like, I think that's why he's like, the only way to do this is to somehow take this unobtainium kind of obstacle and, like, put it into the hands of the oppressed.
Yeah.
And I think that's beautiful.
No, listen. Killmonger was right. So he defeats T'Challa, takes the heart-shaped herb, which sends you to the Ancestral Plane. When T'Challa goes to the Ancestral Plane, he sees his father and all the Black Panthers before him.
I know that's just green screen, but what a cool
effect. It's so great. And they did a great job. The visual effects team on that shot just crushed it. All of the design in this movie, though, the visual design language in this new film is beautifully done.
This feels like therapy. He's like back as an adult with like this different perspective.
While going into my things.
I find it interesting that you say that and then he sees himself as a kid.
What did you find?
Your home.
I gave you a key hoping that you might see it someday. Yes.
So,
sets there are the most beautiful in the world.
Sterling K. Brown is a Tucci. He needs to be in every movie. It makes everything better.
Stanley Tucci?
Yeah. Yeah.
They will say you are lost.
But I'm right here.
No tears for me?
Everybody dies. It's just life around here.
There it is.
Well, look at what I've done.
But then he does cry.
I should have taken you back long ago. Instead, we are both abandoned here.
Well, maybe your home's the ones that's lost. That's why they can't find us.
So to your point, Alan, that Killmonger is right. Wakanda has the means to help the people of the world.
Yeah.
And I think it's so pointed and beautiful. You know, the balance of the screenplay is so smart. And it is as much a call for Black leadership as it is for white repentance. Mm. You know? And it's just so powerful the way it's done because I watched it, and as a white man, like, I felt everything that it wanted me to feel. Like, I come from a position of privilege. I come from a position of power. I have a duty and a responsibility to use whatever means and platform and position I have to make a difference and to help people who are less fortunate or who don't have the opportunities that I have. But at the same time, I never felt the movie say, white people bad. I did feel it say, colonization bad,
yep.
Oppression bad, and that it has historically been white people who have done that, but I never felt that this movie saw white people as the enemy, and that is, it is powerful.
If the goal was to be like, there's a better way to be and interact, and then to like shame people, it like would be so counterproductive.
Yeah.
To it is very brilliant, and I think you hit it on the head where it's like, look at how the black people learn and grow.
People can be like, yeah, this isn't about me, is it?
You know where I'm from. When black folks started revolutions, they never had the firepower or the resources to fight their oppressors. Where was Wakanda? Hmm? You know how that ends today. We got spies embedded in every nation on Earth, already in place. I know how colonizers think, so we're gonna use their own strategy against them.
Calls everyone out.
We're gonna send vibranium weapons out to our war dogs. They'll arm oppressed people all over the world so they can finally rise up and kill those in power and their children and anyone else who takes their side. It's time they know the truth about us.
See, Okoye, like, I'm checking out. No.
The world's gonna start over, and this time we're on top. The sun will never set on the Wakandan Empire.
Wakanda has survived for so long by fighting when only absolutely necessary.
Wakanda survived in the past this way, yes. But the world is changing, General.
I love the warning she gives him with her eyes.
Mm-hmm. It is getting smaller. The outside world is catching
wheels.
And soon it will be the conquerors or the conquered. I'd rather be the former.
She can't believe it.
You heard your orders. Let's get to it.
What are you thinking, man?
Oh, I just like, I don't know. Like, is he wrong? If in a different perspective to be like, there's so many oppressed people, let's give them ways to fight back. You'd be like, that's actually like, that's kind of cool.
That's some Star Wars
shit. Exactly. I think Star Wars. Yes.
Got a bad feeling about this.
I mean, yeah, he said it kind of mean, and you're like, you said it like a bad guy, but if he was like, hey guys, I've been thinking, what if we, you know, you'd be like, that's actually a good idea.
The difference is, he's saying Star Wars rebel rhetoric, right? Mm-hmm. But he's also saying, I want to be the Emperor.
Yeah.
And that's the problem.
It's like, you're not looking to remove the idea of the oppressed, you're just looking to swap it.
You're just looking to change who the oppressor is.
Yeah.
Well, so the whole two wrongs don't make a right thing. This is eye for an eye, you know?
Yeah.
They did this to us, so we're going to do it to them.
Kuba. Why didn't you bring the boy home? Why, Baba? He was the truth I chose to omit. You were wrong to abandon him. I chose my people. I chose Wakanda. Our future depended
on... You were wrong! Oof. All of you are wrong! To turn your backs on the rest of the world! We let the fear of our discovery stop us from doing what is right. No more!
There it is.
I cannot stay here with you. I cannot rest while he sits on the throne. He is a monster of our own making. I must take the mantle back. I must right these wrongs.
Such a cool nerd, Chadwick. T'Challa.
Fine, T'Challa, we will party with you.
Yeah, fine, you can come. It's such an empowering moment, right?
Yeah.
To see him have that shift of, okay, yes, we weren't the right ones, okay, but I know, but to like make the resolution to like do something.
Yeah.
Or to make a difference, especially facing his father who he loves and respects so much.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, he was prepped to carry on that legacy, right?
Mm-hmm.
We stay secluded, we protect ourselves, we have a good thing going here, you know, no need to mess with it.
He's looking at a long history of Black Panthers, a long history of the Kings of Wakanda, and he's telling all of them that they're wrong and Killmonger's right. Killmonger's going about it the wrong way and I gotta go stop him, but he's a monster that you made.
Yeah.
That we made, and I have to take responsibility. Like, I have to remove him, but also change everything we've been doing to do what he would do in a less violent way. How often do you get that out of a movie? Come on.
Right. And also that juxtaposition in Killmonger and T'Challa, where Killmonger's like, I'm gonna make you pay. And T'Challa's like, I understand where you're coming from, but I have to stop. You know, it's like mercy almost coming about it from like a merciful sense.
Yeah. But a lot of people lash out because they feel unheard. They lash out because they feel disrespected. They lash out because what matters to them is going dismissed, right? Yeah. We get ugly when we're hurting. If you're in an abusive relationship, I don't want you to think, well, they're hurting, so I should stay and hear them. Like, yeah, go ahead and get out. That person is hurting, and if they're abusive, then they need to see someone like me to figure out ways to deal with that hurt in a way that isn't violent or vicious.
Yeah.
And you know, sometimes they're just assholes. I mean, that's also a thing.
No!
And so we need to make space to hear each other, even when it's uncomfortable. And that's what I love about T'Challa is, at first, he doesn't want to hear Killmonger because it's an uncomfortable thing to face.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to look at it. But at a certain point, Killmonger makes himself heard, and T'Challa can't run from it anymore.
I don't need a suit to kill you.
Your reign is over. You sat up here safe and protected.
You want to see us become just like the people you hate so much.
Divide and conquer the land as they did.
Nah, I learned from my enemies. Beat them at their own game.
You have become them. You will destroy the world, Wakanda included.
The world took everything away from me. Everything I ever loved. But I'm gonna make sure we're even. I'm gonna track down anyone who would even think about being loyal to you. And I'm gonna put their ass in the dirt right next to Zuri.
I just noticed that Killmonger growls instead of screaming.
Yeah.
Dude, like a panther. He's so cat-like. The, like, inner city cat version of the prince, you know?
T'Challa nails it. You have become them, you know?
Yeah.
He never said he didn't want to become them. I think that's literally what he was trying to do, was climb the system that he was bred in and forced to, you know, grow strong in.
Well, he doesn't see outside that system.
Mm-hmm. He doesn't see outside of it.
And he would see T'Challa's compassion as weakness.
Mm-hmm. But, like, I always think about this where it's, like, so true. But, like, why should he see it as strength? You know, like, at what point is it, like, shown as a strength?
Has it served him that someone was compassionate to
him? Has it served anyone? Killmonger wants to change the world and wants to change it fast and radically, which I'm like, that's my biggest concern. But, like, other than that, you're like, he kind of was pretty impressive. Like, he got up to that point of his own volition and was going to shake and bake things up.
Yeah. In some ways, he's got very good leadership skills. He's got a clear vision. Oh, he communicates it clearly. He's got a lot of power behind it. When he threatens his subordinates by choking
when
that woman.
Yeah, that's when I was like, bro, you're not going to win anyone with this.
Well, that's when you say, like, you got to put something in there to make sure everyone knows he's the villain. Like, have him threaten an old lady.
Plus,
like,
him standing there backlit with the heart-shaped room all on fire.
That's so bad. Like,
and powerful.
When T'Challa is calling him out for the flaws in his thinking, the flaws in his plan, that's when he counters with, they took everything from me, everything I loved. He's now talking about emotion.
Yeah.
And I'm going to, and anyone who's ever loyal to you, I'm going to put them in the dirt. Like, these are not the rational thoughts. And it's a testament to how much you relate to and sympathize with Killmonger. You talk about all the things that he did on his own steam and own power to get here, that when T'Challa stabs him, you feel sad. And I'm a white person. I was about to be oppressed. And I was like, oh, he didn't get to accomplish his goals. He worked so hard for him.
Give him a chance.
Yeah, give him a chance.
It might work out okay.
Nothing says trustworthy ruler like the last name Killmonger.
My pop said Wakanda was the most beautiful thing you ever seen. He promised he was going to show it to me one day. You believe that? Kid from Oakland running around believing in fairy tales.
That is just a heartbreaking line in his delivery.
Acting.
And Chadwick Boseman.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's a great scene without Chadwick there. Chadwick there takes it to freaking Shakespeare.
Yeah, I agree. He gives so little but so much.
And this, at the end, I think it's so poetic and tragic that at the end, someone shows him kindness. His enemy doesn't just leave him there to die, which is what he would have done.
Yeah. And that shot. Whoever the matte painter is.
He's beautiful. Maybe we can still heal you.
Why? So you can just lock me up? No.
Just bury me in the ocean with my ancestors that jumped from the ships. Because they knew death was better than bondage.
I forgot that was still in there.
Good job, guys. You broke me.
I don't want you to speak for the black community because that would be ridiculous, but I would like for you to speak for yourself. How does that scene speak to you?
There's like so much symbolism in it, right? That's like what he's wanted the whole time was freedom. Was freedom from oppression, freedom from where he grew up and the lack of opportunities, freedom from the pain of like having a shattered family and not belonging anywhere. His anger, his hurt is what kind of propelled him and maybe made him successful in all these venues as like a black operative, you know? And I even see that knife coming out as like, the only way he's gonna get freedom is by moving on to another plane, being like not even being able to be in the struggle anymore. The struggles and pains of a whole community, like a black community, is just like all behind Killmonger.
Yeah.
We don't resonate with T'Challa. And I look at this and I'm like, I know Killmonger wasn't supposed to be the hero, but like, honestly, he's like pretty dang inspiring to me in this movie.
Most people want love and respect and safety, right? And a lot of the hurtful things we do come from misguided attempts to get love, respect, or safety, or from feeling like we haven't got those things. Mm-hmm. And so we're either seeking them or we're now it's retribution because I didn't get them, right? And that is small scale in our family relationships and our romantic relationships. It's large scale on societies and nations and across the globe. Killmonger is right. Something needs to be done.
Right.
But what happens with Wakanda is Wakanda can lead with compassion and Wakanda can lead with, okay, we're going to use what we have to help.
Mm-hmm.
And so instead of only the strongest survive, it should be the strongest lead out and making a difference.
Right.
And I love that speech, you know, that he gives at the end where he talks about the things that unite us are more than the things that divide us. And in times of fear, the wise build bridges while the foolish build walls. The way forward is only possible because both of them existed. So we're going to do a T'Challa episode at some point.
Once we know a little bit more about what happened, R.I.P. Chadwick.
What happens with the character, is his arc truly finished? Because with the psychology, we like to do these once the character arcs are done. And so we weren't sure what was going to happen with T'Challa, which is why we're leading with Killmonger, because he's dead.
No!
Stacey, where can people find you?
At Stacey Harkey on Instagram, on like TikTok and stuff, but check out JK Studios on YouTube to see the work I do.
Thank you for joining us and for adding your voice to this conversation.
Oh, thanks for having me. This was fun.
Could we all just wrap it up and go home?
So until next time, in times of crisis, the wise build bridges while the foolish build barriers.
I'm going to feed you to my children.
Just kidding, we're vegetarians.
And Wakanda forever! Yeah.